The Israel Defense Forces, IDF, released a video of its Iron Dome air defense system filling the sky with interceptor missiles as more than 100 rockets rained down on the capital Tel Aviv and other parts of Israel. Tensions between Israel and Hamas soared this week as Palestinian militants began firing rockets at Israel and Israel conducted airstrikes on targets in Gaza in a serious upsurge of violence. The recent fighting seems to be some of the most intense since the 2014 conflict. There are many injured and several dead. One of the most important defensive platforms Israel has at this point in time is the famous Iron Dome system. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how Iron Dome is protecting Israel. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. In the 1990s, Hezbollah, based in Lebanon, fired rockets into the northern part of Israel. This established a need for a system which could counter this threat. During the 2006 Second Lebanon War, the situation worsened. Hezbollah fired approximately 4,000 rockets, mostly the short-range Katyusha. The main targets of these rockets were the northern part of Israel, including Haifa, the country's third-largest city. The rocket onslaught resulted in deaths of 44 Israeli civilians. Not only this, approximately 250,000 Israeli citizens had to be evacuated, and an estimated 1 million Israelis were confined in or near bomb shelters during the assault. In the period between 2000 and 2008, 8,000 projectiles were launched in the southern part of Israel, mainly by Hamas. It's estimated that 50% of these were rockets and the other 50% were mortar bombs. The rockets were mostly Qassams, launched by 122mm Grad launchers from Gaza Strip. The Qassam has a longer range than previous rockets, and almost 1 million civilians were within its range. These increased Israel's determination to find a solution to this security challenge. In 2007, after a lot of evaluations, Israel's defense minister, Amir Peretz, selected Iron Dome for defense against short-range threats. In 2011, Israel began operating the Iron Dome officially. The Iron Dome weapon defense system is the lowest layer of Israel's multi-layered air and missile defense umbrella. It's a mobile, all-weather air defense system developed by Rafael Advanced Defense Systems and Israel Aerospace Industries. It consists of three components: radar, battle management component, and missile launcher. The system uses the radar to detect incoming projectiles. The radar tracks the projectile and sends information to the battle management component. The battle management component examines where the incoming projectiles will hit, and if the area of impact is estimated to fall in its purview, it commands the missile launcher to fire interceptors to neutralize the target in midair. Iron Dome has a first-of-its-kind multi-mission launcher that's designed to fire a variety of interceptor missiles. The interceptor is chosen depending on the threat. Iron Dome's Tamir interceptor missiles can strike down incoming threats launched from ranges of 2.5 miles or 4 kilometers to 44 miles or 70 kilometers. Tamir missile is equipped with electro-optical sensors and steering fins with proximity fuse blast warheads. Each Iron Dome battery includes 3 to 4 stationary launchers with 20 Tamir missiles and a battlefield radar. A single battery can defend up to nearly 60 square miles. Iron Dome is considered to be the most used missile defense system. 10 Iron Dome batteries protect Israel. According to Israel, it's been used to intercept more than 1,500 targets with a greater than 90% success rate since it was deployed in 2011. Though the data regarding success rate is often challenged by critics, there's no doubt the system has seen extensive real-world usage. Last year, Iron Dome was tested with the inclusion of significant upgrades. Regarding the upgrade, Rafael's Vice President Pini Youngman said in a statement, "We've completed a series of tests with a success rate of 100%. The system intercepted all threats, which were simulated in an area secured for the purpose of the experiment." According to Israel's Defense Ministry, the test targets simulated the future threats that the system may confront. Moshe Pitel, the head of IMDO, or Israel Military Defense Organization, stated, "When we deliver it to the Israel Defense Forces, the Air Force will be equipped to confront evolving threats in the region." He further added that these first deliveries of the upgraded Iron Dome systems would begin in the near future. The Israeli military has not revealed any specific details regarding the exact enhancement made. While Iron Dome is not impenetrable, it is a genuine lifesaver. Iron Dome was designed for exactly this kind of situation which Israel is facing now. It's an effective solution. For example, currently, the U.S. Army's primary air defense weapon is the Patriot surface-to-air missile system. But Patriot interceptors cost around $2 million each. This makes it hard to acquire in large numbers, and if limited numbers are available, then the system could be easily overwhelmed. Iron Dome is way cheaper. Tamir interceptor used by Iron Dome has a reported unit cost of $100,000 to $150,000. This means a battery of Iron Dome consisting of 20 Tamir interceptors can be deployed for the cost of about a single Patriot interceptor missile. This makes it far more cost-effective. The fact that Iron Dome has seen significant usage since its deployment is actually a blessing. It's seen several rounds of optimizations, which is only possible when the system faces real-life tests and chinks are identified. This is what makes the Iron Dome a unique asset for Israel.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.